The first full unification of SU3 cross SU2 cross U1 into a simple group was the Georgi-Glashow SU5 model, in which the strong, weak, and electromagnetic interactions are unified above the scale MX much greater than MZ of SU5 braking. Thus, the properly normalized standard model gauge couplings extrapolated from low energy should meet at MX. The left chiral quark, anti-quark, lepton and anti-lepton are unified in the same multiplets in SU5. This implies electric charge quantization since there are no U1 factors. It also predicts proton and bound neutron decay mediated by the new gauge bosons that connect quarks with leptons and quarks with anti-quarks. The original model was eventually excluded by searches at Super-Kamiokande and elsewhere. We will describe the structure and some of the implications of the non-supersymmetric SU5 model. SU5 is a rank 4 group like the standard model, with fundamental 5x5 matrices. The upper left 3x3 block corresponds to the SU3 subgroup, while the lower right 2x2 block corresponds to SU2. There are 12 additional gauge bosons X and Y, which carry both SU2 and color indices. The 24 adjoint gauge fields can be written as a 5x5 matrix, where W and B are the SU2 cross U1 bosons, and G are the gluon fields. Each fermion family of left chiral fields is assigned to a reducible 5 plus 10 representation, where the 5 chi is anti-fundamental and the 10 psi is the anti-symmetric product of two 5s. The field content can be written explicitly, where the family indices and weak eigenstate superscript are suppressed. We also introduce a real adjoint Higgs multiplet 5 and a fundamental complex 5 plet H that contains the standard model Higgs doublet. The 5 fields have the same quantum numbers as the gauge fields and are introduced to break SU5 down to SU3 cross SU2 cross U1. The fermion gauge interactions are written, where the fields are weak eigenstates and a sum over families is imposed. The gauge covariant derivatives are shown, where G5 is the SU5 gauge coupling. Lagrangian for standard model includes the kinetic energy terms in the standard model fermion gauge interactions, with the restriction that the gauge couplings are unified. Lagrangian for XY contains the leptoquark and diquark interactions of the X and Y. Since the X and Y act both as leptoquarks and diquarks, both baryon and leptron number are violated, leading to proton and bound neutron decay. Prominent modes predicted by SU5 included proton goes to positron neutral pion, positron neutral rho, positron omega, positron eta, and so on. The SU5 prediction of proton decay motivated a number of sensitive searches involving large underground detectors. These eventually excluded most of the predicted range of lifetimes. Proton decay continues to be a stringent constraint on more modern versions of grand unification, which usually predict longer lifetimes. The adjoint Higgs phi has a potential. SU5 is broken to SU3 cross SU2 cross U1 at the gut scale. 12 of the scalars in phi are eaten by the X and Y. To further break SU3 cross SU2 cross U1 down to SU3 cross U1Q, one must utilize the phi plet HA. The potential for phi is extended, where the SU5 indices are contracted in an obvious way, and phi goes to minus phi invariance would imply C equals delta equals zero. Two severe fine-tuning problems immediately arise, the gut hierarchy problem and the doublet-triplet splitting problem. Both of these enormous hierarchies must emerge from the parameters in V, phi H. The Yukawa couplings are written, where M and N are family indices, capital gamma is symmetric, and epsilon is anti-symmetric. The fermion masses are generated from HA. The SU5 symmetry predicts that the d-quark and charged lepton mass matrices are the same up to a transpose because they derive from the same coupling. the second and third terms lead to the U-quark and Dirac neutrino mass matrices. We have seen that the properly normalized SU3 cross SU2 cross U1 gauge couplings should all be equal at MX, implying that the value of the running weak angle is predicted where we use the minimal subtraction angle. To compare with experiment, the couplings must be run to low energy. Plugging an alpha S about 0.1 to an alpha about 1 over 128 at MZ yields the angle about 0.20 and MX about 10 to the 15th GeV, which is a reasonable zeroth order prediction. However, more precise two-loop calculations with the current inputs do not quite work.